In this video, we're going to be comparing this Ouxi V8 e-bike versus the Emoko C91 e-bike. These bikes are very similar in price and specifications. Both come with a 48 volt 15 amp hour battery. Both come with a 1000 watt hub motor. The Ouxi V8, this one specifically, is outfitted with 750, but there is a 1000 watt option. Now, the main difference with the Emoko C91 is it has a rear suspension over the Ouxi, which is a hardtail or no rear suspension, only front suspension. Both bikes are outfitted with 20 inch diameter wheels that are 4 inches wide, but the Ouxi has mag wheels over the spoke wheels on the Emoko. They both have front and rear mud fenders, and they both have front suspension. Now, with regard to the seat height is 33 inches on both of these bikes. The Emoko bike seat is a little bit shorter in length compared to the Ouxi. Now, the Ouxi, you could probably fit two people on this. I wouldn't want to ride for very long on with two people, but you could definitely do that. Now, the only option between both of these bikes is the color of the seat. You can get black or brown on the Ouxi, and same thing with the Emoko. I would say the top speed is comparable on both these bikes if they're outfitted with 1000 watt motors, as the controller is about the same output. Now, if you opt for the 750 watt hub motor on the Ouxi V8, the benefit to that is you will have longer range over the 1000 watt motor, but you will lose top end speed, as the Ouxi V8 only gets to about 28 miles an hour with the 750 watt hub motor, and the Emoko gets to about 31 to 32 miles an hour. They both came with mechanical brakes. The Ouxi, the mechanical brakes were terrible. At least the Emoko mechanical brakes were decent, as the pads were larger, but I have since upgraded both of them to hydraulic brakes, and I have how-to videos on to buy. Now, both bikes come with a monochrome screen. The Ouxi has a slightly larger monochrome screen, but they both come with a 7-speed transmission, which is a nice feature for this price point. I do like the handlebars on the Ouxi because it's slightly higher with the raised or bowed handlebars over the Emoko, but I could easily change those handlebars out. Features that are on the Emoko over the Ouxi is, I like it comes with this little bell, and it also comes with a USB port on the battery and a nice battery tester, which is very nice. Now, both batteries are 15 amp hours, and the Ouxi V8 has a similar battery tester but no USB port on that side. But one thing that the Ouxi does have is it does have directionals, which is only in the rear. But it is a nice feature, and the horn is integrated into the switch, whereas over here on the Emoko, there's only a bell. The light you have to turn on with the positive switch, and there's no horn. So other than that, these bikes are very comparable. Now, both of these bikes are really fun to ride and are cool looking compared to most e-bikes. So in conclusion, I can't say which one of these bikes is my favorite over the other. They each have features that benefit each other. Now, in my opinion, whichever bike that you can get for a better price, I would go after. I would say if you're limited on space, go for the Ouxi V8 because it is about 10 centimeters or 4 inches shorter than the Emoko. Now, the Emoko is faster, and I do like that USB port. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comments below, and I hope that you like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching.